Hello everyone, and thanks for coming back to Gallant Griffin. Now before this video gets started, I want y'all to take a gander at the description, and please join the Discord link down there, as it'll take you to the server that I share with my fellow Blockbox people, which if you don't know, Blockbox is the channel I share with my friends, which you should also go subscribe to, because it is very cool and we make cool stuff. Anyways, now on with the video, bye. With the release of Deltarune Chapter 2, I thought I'd cover the topic on everyone's minds, Undertale. Well, it may not be on everyone's minds, but it is a topic I want to revisit while the hype is still here. I guess it's ironic that I'm covering Undertale and this song isn't even in the game, but truth be told, I associate this song more with Alphys than any of her other in-game themes. That's how powerful it is. To get an understanding of this, let me explain a bit about Alphys' character. In every route besides the genocide one, you really get to see her character fleshed out, especially in True Pacifist. She leads you through Hotland, creating false dangers to save you from so that you can trust her and she can become a hero in your story. But when Metaton takes over in the end, she's left near powerless, and with the only thing she can do is call you and pray you survive the encounter. That's only the neutral route, and without exploring the game further, she comes across as cowardly and selfish. With the context of the True Pacifist route, however, the monsters she keeps with her, pun intended, are revealed, and she gains more sympathy from the audience. I would go as far to say that she's the most relatable character in the whole game, apart from maybe Napstablook. That doesn't mean that we can't find ways to relate to the other characters, nor does that make her the best character, but it is important to note that we have monsters that we keep locked away ourselves. The question becomes then, do we overcome our monsters, or let them consume us? Then comes the genocide route, and with the pieces put together, we can infer that Alphys has to overcome her guilt and step into a role of leadership in order to save everyone. Some people would say that they'd prefer her fan-made fight to be in the game, and although it would fit well with her character arc, I'm very thankful that Toby Fox went the direction with her the way he did. This may come as a shock considering the title of the video is referring to her battle theme, but I'll explain how this still fits. The headcanon that I possess is that Alphys Takes Action is the theme that is playing in her head as she is leading others to safety. Through all of the chaos happening, she is finally taking action and battling with her guilt and grief for the sake of everyone. It may not be a traditional battle theme, but I guarantee that is still hers. Not everyone has to fight the villain head-on to be the hero. I mentioned before that Alphys is the most relatable character, and that's most evident when Alphys Takes Action is introduced. Where the question is reintroduced, do we let our monsters consume us, or do we overcome them by taking action? So not only is this song perfect for Alphys herself, but it fits so well within our own lives. Everyone has their own battles, and everyone can choose to take action and fight them in their own ways. By leading everyone out of danger, she is fighting you, the player, in her own way. Thank you.